Hello everybody, welcome back. And if you're new, my name is Chris. Tonight's video is going to be a little quick and a little bit different. It is a this versus that, or which one is better. And in the case of these two fragrances, well, they're both fantastic. And I'm talking about two fragrances by Kajal, and that is Dahab and Lamar. And the reason I'm doing a this versus that is that I couldn't decide which fragrance I wanted to buy. I knew I wanted to buy one, and I went back and forth and back and forth, and I actually went through two different fairly large samples or decants, which was expensive in and of itself, buying two, because I think each sample was around $12. And in the end, I ended up ordering both because I enjoyed both. I couldn't pick one over the other. I think one of these fragrances is better suited for the warmer months, and I think one of these fragrances is better suited for the colder months. And Max Aroma had a 20 or 25% off snap sale, so that did it. I got a really good deal. I bought both bottles, but I would have loved to have a comparison video between the two. And about 5 minutes before I sat down to do this video, I quickly looked in YouTube, and what do you know? There's actually a very big YouTuber who did the same comparison. Now, for transparency's sake, I did not watch it, and I don't like to watch videos of fragrances I'm going to discuss, because I didn't want it to change what I said. If I say the same thing, and it's Sebastian who has the same video. If I say the same thing, well, that's good. If I say something different, well, you guys know that he's wrong, and and I obviously have the better nose. But no, even if we say something different, I think that sometimes differing opinions can add value. So I'm going to make this fast, and I'm going to dive right in. So let's start off with Lamar. Lamar is, in my opinion, the fragrance that is better suited for the cold. This is a thicker, heavier fragrance compared to Dahab. This one is, I think it's famous for being based on pineapple. And I don't think that this, in my opinion, is a simple pineapple. We have a lot of pineapple in this house. I have a picky eater, a child that's a very picky eater. And I'm always insisting on my children eat fruit and or vegetable at every meal. That's just kind of my thing. And my son, he likes fruits, but his favorite fruit is pineapple. And he will just eat that by the bowl. And so I always have pineapple around. So I know what a pineapple smells like. I have cut probably, I mean, hundreds and hundreds of pineapples because of it. So this, in my opinion, is not a pineapple that you cut. This is not a freshly cut pineapple. This, in my opinion, is a pineapple that is grilled. I'm a big griller. I'm from the South. I'm from Texas, and we grill just about everything, including fruits. And when you grill a fruit, it kind of takes on a little bit of a different character. It becomes a little bit sweeter. It's when those sugars caramelize, it becomes a little bit more syrupy. It's a little bit sweeter and a little bit denser, I guess is the word I'm looking for. So there is definitely, I definitely get pineapple in here, but it's pineapple plus. It is this, in my opinion, slightly caramelized, slightly thicker, little bit syrupy pineapple that is mixed with berries. I believe there's red berries in here, and there's definitely a white floral. There is probably jasmine, and I think I read magnolia. I have a magnolia tree in my backyard, and that has a very specific scent to it. I don't pick up magnolia per se, but I definitely pick up a heady white flower. My nose is very sensitive to jasmine, and some jasmine, I enjoy some jasmine, just a little too indolic for me. So there is a little bit of a heady jasmine in here that I think kind of adds to the depth and character of this fragrance. So it definitely has a floral touch to it. As it starts to dry down, you can pick up the rose. The rose, in my opinion, is not as prominent as the white florals are. And maybe my nose is just a little bit more sensitive, but it takes a while, for me at least, to smell the rose in here. And as it kind of continues to dry down, this is a fairly strong fragrance. This really holds up. This has been holding up nicely in the cold. We are in the end of November, the day after Thanksgiving, and it's very, very cold today. And as it dries down, it gets a little bit more vanillic. The musk starts to come out and it's a little bit woody. I think it's cedar. Cedar is the wood in here. So it dries down into a woody, florally musk. In my opinion, this is the fragrance that's better suited for the cold. That's just me out of the two. Now we will go to Dahab. I love this fragrance. This is a gorgeous, and again, these bottles are just, come on, like they are beautiful. The lights are so bright in here. I have big bright lights, so you might not be able to see the plate, but gorgeous. These bottles are just so beautiful. The lids and everything, very sharp. They can be used as a weapon if you're not careful. So Dahab is a fruity, ambery musk. The notes in here are very different. This is a gorgeous, this to me is better suited for the warmer months, the warmer weather. I would definitely wear this, absolutely wear this in the warmer months. I have tried to wear this in the cold, doesn't do great. It's not heavy enough in my opinion, and I think it's perfectly suited for the warmer months because it has some really nice, pleasant, light notes. There is a gorgeous passion fruit note in here and a gorgeous apple. I love apple and fragrances. So this is a beautiful passion fruit, apple, green apple opening. It has the perfect sweetness and the perfect accompanying tartness. It's sweet and tart at the same time. The sweetness probably comes from like a sweet green apple, even though green apple tends to be tart. And the tartness probably comes from passion fruit. I don't have a lot of passion fruit, but the few times I've had like a passion fruit sauce or a passion fruit drizzle or coulis, it tends to be tart. It's a little bit on the tart side. It's very bright. These fruits are bright, but they're not overripe. And even though it is sweet and fruity, it is sweet and fruity in a sophisticated way. It is definitely the prettiest passion fruit based fragrance that I have ever smelled. And as it dries down, it gets, there is musk, there's a beautiful ambery sweetness, and it has patchouli in it probably so that it can give it some depth and so it lasts longer. Patchouli is used in most fragrances to make fragrances last and give them a little bit of depth. I'm a big patchouli fan. Haven't always been a big patchouli fan. My tastes have certainly evolved over the past 20 years. Gorgeous fragrance. The amber in here, this is a light amber. It's the musk in here is very clean and bright, and the patchouli and the amber are also light. They are not heavy. They are not thick. They are not syrupy like Lamar. This one is a heavier, more syrupy fragrance. This is a lighter, more airy fragrance for sure. Even though it is sweet and fruity, the amber gives it kind of a little sophisticated depth, and the passion fruit tartness keeps it from being too sweet. And I think the musk in here also helps keep it from being too sweet. I enjoy sweet fragrances. The sweetness in here is kind of perfectly balanced and offset by the tartness and the musk, which gives it a little bit of freshness, and the patchouli, I think, grounds it. So my quick take on these two gorgeous fragrances, they are very, very different in my opinion. And I certainly don't think you need both, even though they're different enough. And again, the only reason I bought both is because I got them at such a good price. And now that I have both and I had to choose one, I don't know which one I would choose. Lamar is definitely longer lasting and heavier, and Dahab is lighter and sweeter and something that I could easily pull off in the summer. So because I think these work best in different climates, I'm okay with having both, and I can justify my purchase for both of them. So that's it. My quick, that probably was no more than 5 minutes, my quick take on these two fragrances. I hope that it helped you and that you don't struggle between the two of them like I do. And again, they're both expensive enough that blind buying, not the best idea. And samples are kind of readily available. I found samples at lots of different places. So, and if you want me to list where I got my samples, I can. I'm happy to do that. But that's it. Dahab versus Lamar. Thank you for sticking around. Thank you for watching me. Thank you for supporting me. And I will see you on the next one.